Good afternoon, Year 3, and welcome to Geography Lesson 3. So today our TRP is, can I understand and use the 8 compass points? And can I use this to learn about the counties of England? Do you remember we talked about counties as being a larger area of land within a country? So, questions. What is a compass? And what compass points do you already know, if you know any at all? Okay, so there's a picture of a compass on this page. You may have seen something that looks like it. Long before GPS satellites and sat-navs, the compass gave humans an easy and cheap way to orient themselves. No matter where you stand on Earth, you can hold a compass in your hand and it will point towards the North Pole. So, if you know the direction you need to travel in, you can use a compass to help you. Now, the main 4 compass points, which you may well have heard of already, are north, east, south, and west. And we can remember these in a range of ways. And we can say, never eat shredded wheat. Or we can say, naughty elephants squirt water. And if we move in a clockwise direction, so that this way, around the compass, that will help us to remember the 4 main points. Now, to create 8 points, what you do is you look in between the 4 main points. So, between north and east, the direction of the compass is called northeast, and it's often shortened to NE. Between east and south, the direction is called southeast. Between south and west, southwest, and between west and north, it's northwest. And you always start with either north or south. So you don't say east-south, you just say southeast. And as I said, they're often abbreviated to NE, SE, SW, and NW. So for example, because Brighton is in the southeast corner of the United Kingdom, we say we live in southeast England or southeast of Great Britain. Okay, so you don't actually need to use a compass for the task today, but it's quite good fun if you've got one to take it out and have a little go at it. So in your packs at the end of year 2, you should have all been given a little mini compass like this, so you can get this out and try and use it. Now, I can twist it as much as I like. Maybe I'll put it on my hand so you can see it even more clearly. If I can twist it as much as I like, but the north will always be in the same direction. And in this classroom, it's actually pointing this way. So if we kept walking north, if I kept following that line, I would eventually get to London because we know that's to the north of where we are in Brighton. Now, if you're really lucky, you might have a compass like this at home. This is the kind of one that we use in school. Okay, so similarly, the red part of the arrow points to the north. So you need to take your compass on your hand and settle it. Okay, when it is settled and level, you then twist the plastic part round so that it shows you that north is this way. The reason for lining it up like that is then you will know where east is, south and west, and all of these are 360 degrees around the compass. So if I said you need to go 100 degrees, you would be pointing almost to the east, because east obviously is going to be 90 degrees. So we can use those compasses as well. And look, no matter how much I swivel the compass around, the red arrow is always pointing in the same direction, as long as I keep my hand nice and flat. Okay, if you don't have either of those types of compass, there's also, there are apps you can download quite easily onto a smartphone. Now, the north again is pointing in this direction. In this case, it doesn't work if I try and line this up. What this is showing me instead is how many degrees I am away from north with my arrow. Okay, so that's 122. Look, if I twist it round so it's pointing to east, it should be 90. There we go. Okay, so if you have a chance, have a little fiddle with those compasses and just see in your house which direction is north, which direction is south. Okay. Now, how does this relate to learning about the counties of England? In your packs, you should have a map like this, which shows you all of the counties in England. Doesn't go into Wales, Scotland and Northern Ireland, just has the ones in England for us to learn, because there are quite a lot altogether. Now, can you remember what we talked about last time? We said if you come in on the River Thames, you end up in London, and if you go south from London, you will end up in Brighton, which is the top of this little triangle here. So here it doesn't show our unitary authority of Brighton and Hove, but it does show the larger counties of East Sussex and West Sussex. And we normally say that we are in East Sussex. Okay, so these are the counties. Now, as well as this map, you should also have a list of what all of these funny shortened names mean. So for example, Less, that one there, is Leicestershire. South York's South Yorkshire, and so on. So for today's lesson, you're going to need this sheet, and I'm going to ask you some questions using directions. Okay, so we have our map, we have our questions. I've also quickly drawn these compass points, north, east, south, and west. Okay, let's see if we can answer a couple of these questions together. So which county is south of Norfolk? So our first job is to have a really good look, see if we can find Norfolk on our map. Oh, it's over here, right in the east of the country. Now, the question is, which county is south of Norfolk? So if I start in Norfolk and go towards the south, and on maps generally, the north is always at the top of the map and the south is at the bottom. So the answer is Suffolk. So I am going to very carefully try and write Suffolk. Now, because it's the name of a county, it does need a capital. And if I don't know how to spell it, I can check on my map. Okay. That's not too bad. Okay, I'm okay with that. Right, question number two. Which county is west of Staffordshire? And I have helped you out. I've written that it's Staffs. Now, I know that's somewhere in the Midlands. So let me see if I can use my arrow. Oh, there we go. No, so this is Staffs. And the west of Staffs is this direction. Look down here, this direction. So, I mean, I could say Cheshire, but I'd say that's more to the north. So I'm going to go for Shropshire. Shropshire. Now, I'm not going to fit that into my box, so I'm not even going to try and write that on my screen. So your job now is to use your map. Oops, use your map. Use your compass points that I've taught you, and use your questions, which I'm going to show you in a minute. Do your best to answer these, and we will try and mark them on Zoom later. So here are the questions. This is about as big as I can get them. Hopefully you can see them. Have a go at answering them in your book. So it's the back of your English book. Don't need to write the question, just write the answer next to number one, etc. And we'll have a go at marking those on Zoom later. Now, if you look in the box below, there is a link to a little BBC bite-sized video that will also show you how to use compasses for a bit of extra information. See you soon.